By now, you're probably getting tired of everybody's opinion on Certified Lover Boy and Donda. So I was a little reluctant on giving mine, not to be one of those people that had to say something about it and really don't even matter. But I mentioned that I would, and I try to keep my word on everything, so here it is. Having fully digested both albums and knowing the beef between Drake and Kanye, it's hard to not compare the two because they're in two different lanes. One is secular, one is non-secular. One is for a certain Drake fans and one is for kind of gospel, hip-hop, rap type of thing. So it's not the same thing. Not gonna be able to compare the two without comparing to their older selves. So that's, I think, will be the best thing to do. So I'll compare Drake to his prior albums and then briefly run down CLB to Donda. Or against Donda. So I'm gonna do something a little different this time and go over certain categories of an album, which contains lyrics, overall musicality, beats, title, album cover and sequencing, replay value, and marketing. Some of this will blend with one another, so just be patient. As far as lyrics, you can break those down to subcategories. As far as flow or versatility, metaphors, storytelling, subject matter. And to be honest, with Drake's album, it's typical Drake flow, typical rhyming patterns, typical metaphors. There's really not any storytelling going on. He never really was a great storyteller. Same type of subject matter, kind of in his feelings, insecure about trustworthy people, female based records. It's just typical Drake. Nothing more, nothing less. It's consistent Drake. And there's nothing wrong with that. As far as overall musicality, I like the records. I thought, and I'm gonna dip into a little bit of sequencing. The sequencing was pretty good as far as from track to track. But overall, I think the beats were good. They're not great. One standout record was No Friends in the Industry. But I do think some songs sound like leftovers of albums that didn't really manifest, like the Drake and Future album. I guess it's supposed to be called What a Time to Be Alive 2. I like the I'm Too Sexy record. I think it's dope, but I thought the visual sold that record the most, as opposed to me hearing it the first time and liking it, if you get what I'm saying. Now going over the title, Certified Lover Boys, typical Drake. I thought the album cover was pretty horrible, but it does play onto the generational emoji era that we're in right now. And I think from a marketing standpoint was genius as far as people being able to create or twist his album into their own thing. So that in essence promotes Drake's album and further gives it attention. As far as replay value, I think the replay value is higher than Donda, at least for me personally, because it's more of a lyrical album than Donda. Like I said, these are two different albums, so you can't really compare the two. I think musicality on Donda is better because Kanye is always in a state of experimentation, and I can respect that as a producer from him. And like I said, you know, people that don't like Donda are probably former fans of Kanye's older self. So when you think of it on those terms, and then Kanye saying things that probably rub people the wrong way, and very understandably, they're not gonna like Donda, point and simple. But I think the real gem that came out of all this so far right now is Life of the Party with Andre 3000. And with 3000, he just never disappoints. And it also gives us a glimpse of where Dre is at a point in his life. And it was just a beautiful verse about his mother and his father, his state of mind. And it's just him being him. As far as the Kanye diss, I thought it was pretty trash, but I thought that sounded like more of like a freestyle. And I really hated what he did towards the end of that Life of the Party record. But getting back to CLB, overall good album. You know, I give it the same type of rating, 7, borderline 8. Nothing groundbreaking, nothing that makes me want to play it over and over again compared to If You're Reading This, It's Too Late, or Take Care, or Hotline Bling. So that's my take on it. Take it for what it is. See you guys later.